This is the Franklin D. Roosevelt Library, Museum, and Archives. The main home is to the left. We have not added a soundtrack, but have given adequate time for viewers to read and contemplate what they see. This is the 7th of November, and this is about 15 miles from Cody, Wyoming. It's the Japanese internment center, which is really not opened as a museum yet, but I think they're working on it. This evidently was the infirmary where the chimney was. The buildings are behind me, most of the barracks. This was an embarrassing period. One of the embarrassing periods in U.S. history. Right here by me are the barracks. Once again, this is the infirmary. And I'm going to pan to the left. It's really pretty desolate. And there are a number of, right behind me, we'll see it in a minute, poured concrete. Now, there may have been possibly barracks at these sites, like right here. I would guess probably so. Now you see there are two barracks there.
Feeling being here. There's nothing. It makes it sound like they were going to open it next year, but there's nothing done. Maybe we're at the wrong spot, but this is definitely the chimney they said that went to the infirmary.
I'm sure this is it.
And there's a heat location there.
A what? This is the pipe Abe was talking about. He said there's a Japanese fellow, I think from San Francisco, that comes here and spends the summer. He may be the one that's trying to see that this is opened as a... Maybe we're trying to bury this, forget about it. These were U.S. citizens. There's a wire over the window, but what I'm trying to do is film through the window. Pretty bleak. This is the building that was the infirmary. Abe is standing on another slab of concrete. And I think these were probably barracks that they tore down. Doesn't look like they've done anything. I said, probably they're embarrassed. And know what these were. I mean, maybe it's almost like tunnels or... We found, actually found an opening, and this is just a small crack in the boards to film the inside of that infirmary. And I filmed a minute to go through the window. You said there were quite a few internment camps?
Yeah, absolutely.
Throughout the United States?
Yeah, well, they're mainly in the West.
This is looking back on the infirmary. Now this is looking into one of the barracks. Through the screen, it's kind of hard to see. On this post directly in front of me, people who have visited have left a rock or a piece of glass, stone or whatever to show they've been here. And we just deposited the two dark pieces on the right. In my pocket. Abe and I were just getting ready to leave when we ran into a farm fellow who just moved here from Kansas because there was no work. And he's going to try and farm. And he told us right across the street where we are now is the memorial. There's a walk and Abe is photographing the plaques, which I'll bring into the video. There were 11,000 Japanese moved into this camp. And he said with the Homestead Act, they gave the land away, and I guess the farmers tore down a lot of the buildings to farm here. There's a walk over here, and you can walk around. I guess there's site plaques along the walk. And these people are just completing the walk. Very interesting. At the bottom of this, along here, is a picture of the site. This is what the site looked like at the time. That's the infirmary again, and we were totally wrong. Those buildings over there were the infirmary, the shops, etc. And then as we pan down here, that was one of the offices. And if we pan on down here, there's a railroad track, more barracks, but anyway. And there was a tower here, a watchtower also, so the railroad tracks are down there. It's very nicely set up, actually. They have these stations, and you can look out. There's also many cases of magnifying glass that you can look through and see what they're referring to.